and you pay it back when you leave the house. Most people use the money to pay off their existing mortgage or pay some bills, cover medical costs, even update their home. And, just as important, it's a law designed just for America, and it's helped hundreds of thousands to live with a more stable, secure retirement and stay in the home.
AAG is the leader in reverse mortgages. Call us today for your free information check, field us with all your questions, and help you decide if a reverse mortgage is right for you and how to qualify.
I know what you're thinking. I did too. I felt the same way, but I checked it out. It's reverse mortgage. AAG. You get retirement stability. Maybe you
If you're 62 or older and own your own home, give AAG a call to receive your free information kit. You'll receive the information you're looking for, as well as tell you how much cash you may qualify for. Call 1-800-409-7571 today. Already deregulated, but he needs to get Congress on board for the rest of the plan. We know if he has it. Now, it will be easy to take a top-down view of the market. The Dow first rally post-election, because the Republicans had a sweeping victory that no one expected. So that even if Trump's an outsider, he can still get his way, as we've seen with every cabinet nomination so far, even though many people are totally panned by the mainstream media. That's because the Republican legislators are fully aligned. They will fully rely on Trump's economic agenda, too. That's a good thing. That's not even the way I think. That's not my worldview. That's not how, by the way, that's not how it's really done. That's how it may be done with you. Keep it. It's not how it's done in the real life. This is what you do. You don't do top-down analysis. That's for people who don't want to get their hands dirty, or for people who are too lazy to do the work on the companies themselves, which is backbreaking and hard. It means you got to get up early and go to bed late. And people don't want to do that. Somehow out of mind. So when it comes to critiquing the move to top-down 20,000, I prefer actually to evaluate the individual companies in the index. I like bottoms up, not top-down navel gazing. It doesn't help for broad sweeping thing. I mean, look, think about it. You got literally half of the 30 companies in the Dow that have reported earnings. So we have something to work with here. That's why I want to analyze the results of the 15 companies to see if we can justify this move based on the fundamentals. Remember that? Not the animal spirits or Trump or tweets. The dummies. This is a crucial analysis that must be done. Because of all the near misses we had in our last failed assault on 20,000, at the time I told you that there wasn't a good case to be made on the fundamentals, that the move was too based on animal spirits, meaning there was too much sizzle, not enough steak. But I think this time it's good. This time the earnings are a different story. That's why I want to give you a quick and dirty rundown. An encapsulation of the work I've done with 15 Dow members that we've already heard from this earnings season. Because to me, these numbers say, they say this rally's for real. They say you better stop believing. Let's go down the list. First, there's American Express. And even though the stock fell after it reported, I think that was a big mistake by wanton and somewhat ignorant sellers. The last time American Express was earning this amount of money 2 years ago, the stock was in the 90s. I think it's headed back there. Probably below 7%. How about Boeing, VA? Many bears think that this was the quarter where the aerospace titans put out the lower numbers. I kept hearing about that every day. They went and cut numbers. Why? Because of the surfeit of wide-body planes. Others were worried about trade sanctions. After the actual results, though, all you could do was wonder why the heck you didn't own the Darton, especially since the North Tower Streamliner is now a profit center. But eventually, it happened this quarter. The fact that you found your information to make a number and atmosphere of intermittent growth is all about the amazing work of this new CEO. This CEO, his name is Ed Green, and he's merging his company with Dow Chemical. I was blown away by the improvement in gross margin that we were able to bring about. This man is a company. This man, the way I put it, he knows how to cut costs and grow revenues at the same time. That is an outstanding thing. Most CEOs should definitely like number four. All right, here we go, General Electric. I was disappointed in the execution, followed by its oil and gas producer, not to mention that shortfall in the turbine business, which is simply running out of the government flag to use the oil. That's right. In other words, don't look to GE for help now that we've broken above 20,000. Doesn't deserve any help. Okay, if Goldman Sachs can report the kind of monster number it just delivered last week before the deregulation rates, I can't even imagine how much they can earn once that backdrop improves. If the stock still trades at a ridiculous 12 cost earnings, that's insane. Goldman used to trade every year. Any lightning of financial regulation can send this company to orbit. That's right, it's not in orbit yet, but it can get there from here, especially with Fed rate hikes. Exxon traded down this and then the stock when I thought the sellers would walk the lines. Which I figured they'd finish looking at the sellers. Follow the plan, you know. This company's become one of the